Good afternoon. Today is Wednesday, April 24th.
Now over to Jamie with some more announcements.
Thank you. The quote of the day today is, "Always remember that you are absolutely unique, just like everyone else," by Margaret Mead. The lunch for today is a main meal of chili and a hot combo of ham and cheese melt. And the lunch for tomorrow is chicken tenders and no hot combo. Now, over to your weather report.
What's up, you guys? I'm Lindsay.
And I'm Beth.
And this is JJ.
And you know what that means.
It's Weather Wednesday with JJ.
Okay, so today is going to be sunny.
Yep, and it's going to be a high of 68 and a low of 50.
Okay, Jay, now over to...
You little ham.
Three days on from the devastating Easter Sunday bombings that hit a number of locations across Sri Lanka, including this church right behind me in the capital, Colombo, we're learning more about what happened and the threat in the days afterwards. A senior Sri Lankan intelligence official told CNN that the National Tauhid Jamaat, an Islamist group suspected of involvement in those attacks, that it was planning a second wave. This was intelligence discovered after Sunday's attack. We've also learned separately from a person familiar with intelligence that India provided three specific warnings to Sri Lanka in the days and weeks in the run-up to Sunday's attack. The first was on the 4th of April, the second on Saturday, just a day before the Sunday bombings. The last warning came an hour before the first explosion. The junior defense minister of Sri Lanka in a press conference today, he said that he also gave us more information about the bombers themselves, revealing that one, for example, was educated in the UK and in Australia. He also acknowledged the intelligence lapses, something that even as people here try to come to terms with the tragedy, it's angering them. They're asking questions like, why did it happen? If we knew this, why were these people allowed to approach churches such as this one? Nikhil Kumar, Colombo.
Attention any former and or current art student who is interested in learning about a career in ceramics or the field of crafts. This Thursday during Block 5, the Executive Director of the Pennsylvania Guild of Craftsmen, Karen Piper, and ceramic artist Amy Burke will be giving a presentation on their career journey. They will reveal the knowledge, skills, training, and daily responsibilities necessary to be successful in the field of ceramics and crafts. If you are interested in attending the presentation, please see Mrs. Gleason by the end of the day today. Now over to the viral video.
Attention to any senior in need of scholarship money for college. You can still apply for the CVEA scholarship, which is a $4,000 award, $1,000 per year for 4 years. Applications are available in the guidance office. We are looking for students with excellent grades, leadership ability, and financial need for college. The deadline to turn in the application is May 3rd. The award will be given out during the graduation ceremony. Please see Mr. Cap if you have any questions. Come out to read us tonight from 5 to 9 to support NHS's Minithon and enjoy a sweet treat.
Didn't order a yearbook yet? We only have a few left. If you don't want to get one of these amazing books, you will need to stop in the library to see Mrs. King. Don't hesitate or you may be too late. Attention TSA students who have turned in their forms and are interested in attending the Nation Conference in June. Please let Mr. P know before next Tuesday, April 30th, what events you would like to participate in at the conference. You may see Mr. P in room 158 or send an email. Thanks.
Yesterday afternoon, we competed in our first unified track and field competition at Hemfield High School. We finished behind Warwick High School in our second place by 1 point. But more importantly, our athletes had a great time cheering on each other and the other teams. We are 1 week away from hosting our only meet on May 1st at 4 p.m. All staff and students are invited to cheer on our team. Now over to CV Sports.
There's an away baseball game against Ephrata at 7.
There's a home softball game against Ephrata at 4:15.
Come out and support the Bucks.
Now we're to sports highlights.
That's all the announcements we have for you today.
On behalf of WCVH, I'm Sarah.
Alongside Charles.
And this is CB Today.
Have a lot more fun today.
Into a fishbowl, back into the deep blue, like you're on a blurred out video. Always got the best view, leaning out the window.